So to install Ubuntu, you need to install VMware, which is virtual machine ware, in your system, and then create a virtual operating system inside your original operating system. There are two ways to install Ubuntu. One is by making it dual boot, and the other is by making it run through VMware. So we are going with the second method now. So to install VMware and to install Ubuntu in your system, you need to follow these steps. At first, install VMware, which is a normal installation process, and then you need to open it, double click it and open it, and after that you need to create a new virtual machine. You can see these five panels, which you need to click the first one, create virtual machine, and then you need to go to customize, which is an advanced option, and then press next, and then you need to again press next, and then you need to again press next. Then install the ISO file, which is actually an Ubuntu ISO file. It's an operating system, which is an image disk file. You need to browse the location. So here I browse my location. Be careful when you install, please don't add an incorrect ISO file, which will really damage your virtual machine. After browsing, you need to click next, then give the details. You need to mention all the things before. You need to mention the name, then give the details. You need to mention all the things before. You need to mention the name, full name, username, and the password, so that when the operating system opens, it always asks for the password. Ubuntu is a very secure operating system and very safe. Then again you need to browse the location where I have installed in my computer, and then a new location. Always have a new folder for your new virtual machine. You have Ubuntu, then you have a different folder. You have Windows, some other version of Windows, then you have some other, or Android or anything, you need have a different location. Here you set the memory space, how much you need to spend it for your operating system. This will decide your RAM, your memory space taken by your virtual machine, and everything. Your operating system will take a particular space, and this operating system will occupy a particular space. Here you specify the maximum disk size. Here I mention 40. 40 is a recommended size to use Ubuntu with some high-end softwares. And now you finish it. Now this will create a different disk as a virtual disk, which will have an installation in Ubuntu. This process of creating a different disk will be a safer methodology to create a good operating system virtually. While you create this disk virtually, be careful that you don't run any other work, any other task, because this really takes a very high amount of space in your RAM, which will slow down your system.